to lose weight to get a man. What are you willing to give up? Can Ndola?
Oh, you're asking me that?
Hmm?
What am I willing to give up?
Or do you have a question? That's the subject we're talking about tonight. Or do you have a question?
Yeah, I just wanted to know, okay, what can a woman do to fix her situation? Basically, after, okay, let's say she's skinny.
This is you? No, no, give me, is this you?
Okay, you're asking me what
I don't know, because when you start asking, can a woman, and then I don't like to do hypotheticals, so I need it to be more concrete. Are we talking about you?
Okay. Yeah. Like, go
ahead and just say it then. Let's get to it.
Yeah. What would I have to do to better my situation?
How old are you?
Yeah. How old are you?
29.
Yes.
Any children?
Yes, two.
How many different fathers?
Two.
Okay, did you go to college?
I'm in college.
What are you studying?
Biology.
What do you plan on doing with a biology degree?
I want to be a dentist.
What's your classification?
I'm a freshman, yeah.
How long would it take you? How long is dental school?
It's going to take 7 years in total.
Uh-huh. So as soon as you would be, 37, 38 years old?
If I'm 29 now, so 36.
37? 36. Did you just turn 29?
Well, yeah, I turned 29 in January, so.
So you're almost 30?
Yeah.
Like I said, 37?
Yes.
See, what do you mean better your situation? What is the outcome you want?
Well, basically, I feel like dating right now.
Do you want a marriage? What do you want as the outcome?
Oh, okay. Yes, I would love to get married one day.
Uh-huh. You want any other children?
I'm not sure.
Okay. Once you're married and pregnant, and once you're married, do you want to have to pay significant bills in the household?
Because...
What percentage of a family of four, let's just say, your two kids, your husband, and you, what percentage of the family financial load do you want to have to be responsible for a life?
Definitely. Definitely a major, because 1% would probably be over 50%, 50%. Yeah, 50%.
Well, here's the thing. As a 29-year-old woman with two children by two different men and going into freshman college, you don't have time for a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
You really don't. I mean, and which one of your children's fathers is doing better than you?
Is doing better than me? Mm-hmm. They do well for themselves.
Said, what did I say?
Doing better than me.
Uh-huh.
In terms of what way is better than me?
The way that the world...
Like financially? Yeah,
they're
both doing better than me.
Uh-huh. Why didn't you marry either one of them?
I don't know.
Well, see, this is where you ladies end up getting around, because you don't get to do better than your baby daddies. I've said this for so long. Yes, you've already decided to go out and have children by men.
Mm-hmm.
You give a man the highest honor you give a man without being a wife.
Right.
And then a man comes down the pipe. When you're older, more used, he doesn't even get any kids out of the deal and has to put a ring on your finger? No, thank you. Not a man of value. You get a man equal to or less than your baby daddy. And that tends to shock ladies. I say that all the time, but you don't tend to find women in the aggregate.
I don't think my kids that are bad, though. So if I was to find a man...
But they weren't. Did they want to marry you?
Did they want to marry me?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. When you didn't want to marry them. So why should somebody come along and get with a woman who had children with men she didn't want to marry, and then she didn't marry them, and they don't get a kid? No. Makes no sense.
Yeah, I'm so just what being, I'm just can being, I I'm, do? Like, what
nothing,
should I do?
Nothing.
No, you're there done. Has to be
you're,
something.
You're done. You're done.
I'm
Dunzo.
Done?
Done.
It burns! Oh, it burns! Oh.
Done. Let me show you how you're done. Let me show you how you're done. How tall are you?
5'5".
Dress size?
Dress size 8.
How much did you weigh last time you weighed yourself?
180 pounds.
You're not no dress size 8 and 5'5". That is every bit of a 12. I'm an image consultant in real life, and I can see the size of your face. Hold up your hand. Wave. Wave.
Where am I? I'm in Florida.
Say wave, wave.
Oh,
like
wave?
With the hand. Yeah, you got bye-bye arms. That is not a dress size 8. It's every bit of a 12.
Okay.
And see, the fact that you'll come through here lying.
I don't think I'm lying, though, because
I know you're not a dress size 8.
Okay.
I know you're not a dress size 8. And why is it important? Because just like the last lady I was saying, it matters. A man would come to marry you. He gets no children. He's got 2 kids, son, daughter, 2 boys, 2 girls. What do you got?
2 boys.
He has to go raise 2 knucklehead boys from 2 different dudes. He doesn't even get a kid out of this. And then he gets a woman who's almost 200 pounds.
I said
pounds.
Maybe. Possibility.
Oh, no, it doesn't matter. He gets a woman who's almost 200 pounds and wants to be a dentist. So that means your life is not even going to be spent focusing on children. Your life is going to be going to undergraduate and dental school. That's going to be your focus. You don't go to dental school in your part-time. That's what you do when you're young with no children. But you're trying to do what you should have did when you were young with no kids after you've grown with 2 kids from 2 different dudes. And you ask what you can do to better yourself, what sucker would come along and take this and think this is a good deal?
Right.
So when I say it's done, what in your dating life has shown you where men of value are looking to wife you right now, and since you've had your second child?
Mm-hmm. You said what man of value?
Yeah, since your second child, what in your life is... What evidence do you have of men of value looking to wife you?
Looking to wife me? I don't know.
That means you don't. I don't know means they don't exist. I mean, if you want to be going to dental school, it's a scientific mind. This is just about the probabilities, man.
Mm-hmm.
On a scale from 1 to 10. Scale from 1 on a percentage, 0 to 100%. What is a percentage probability you think you'd have of getting
100%?
The probability, not possibility.
The probability would be, I don't know.
That's unacceptable.
I don't know what you want me to say.
I want you as somebody who knows yourself and your situation to see if you have a realistic expectation of what's likely going to happen.
Of marrying someone.
What's the probability? What probability would you give yourself?
I would give myself a once in a lifetime probability.
Out of 100 percentage points, I need a number.
Seventy-five.
So you give yourself a 3 out of 4 chance, 75% chance of getting married.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, judge that based on the fact that 1 in 4 black women can expect to be married in their lifetime. That's a 26% of black women can expect to marry in their lifetime. And you, a woman with 2 children from 2 different men, think you have a 3 times greater chance than the average black woman.
Yes.
Why?
Because I feel like if you want to be married as a Black woman, you have a lot of opportunity. You know, if you give the right person a chance.
Ma'am, 1 in 4 Black women can expect to marry in their lifetime. That's roughly 25%. You gave yourself a 75% chance. That means so you, a Black woman, almost 200 pounds with 2 children from 2 different men.
Yes.
Why do you think you have a better chance, a 3 times better chance than the average Black woman? And don't tell me why you think it's this. There has to be something behind that.
Because I know like women that had these same odds and they're married. So it's not a cut and dry type of ordeal. It's not like,
you guys
okay,
understand, you understand what's going on here. This is what happened on Instagram the other day. Even the women who want to be scientists have a problem with reality. I said probability and possibility. Well, I guess that's the chance. Then I hope are you going to raise your sons this way too, on probabilities or possibilities? Are you going to tell them, are you going to raise them based upon facts, data, statistics, probabilities and likelihoods and odds? Or are you going to just tell them, hey, somebody wins the lottery?
No, it's not even that. It's just that, I mean, there's a lot of factors.
There's not a lot of factors. You got 2 kids from 2 different men. You're almost 30 years old and 200 pounds. You're almost 200 pounds, 2 kids from 2 different men. There's not a lot of factors. It's done. Because you're not even dealing in the realm of in reality. Your attitude isn't even right. Even if a man of value was looking to have a wife, your attitude is shit. You think you're the prize coming through here talking like, oh yeah, I know women who did. That's why I just let this shit ride, man. I'm like, well, okay. And Black women, I want you to understand, this is what you're asking Black men to pick from. This is what Black men are being asked to pick from. So when I say the ground is open for competition, you want your cousins and your brothers to pick from women who, according to her, her 2 children's father wanted to marry her, but she didn't want to marry them. But somebody's supposed to come along later and give her the highest honor of being a wife. And they don't even get kids. You're delusional. But I get it. You got to lie to yourself to see. What I need you to understand, these women who talk like this, and I'm not going to say this is you in particular, but it's generally women who talk like this, they have to lie to themselves to ease the pain of the reality they know is facing them. You know the truth. You just don't like it. And you don't get anywhere in life by just sitting around saying, well, it can happen. When you ask me the probability or the likelihood, and I'm like, well, there's not much that I can see you can do because you don't even necessarily know you want to have kids. So a man doesn't get a kid out of the deal. And then a man would have to come on and raise your 2 sons and get a part of a wife. He'd have to get a part of a wife because your primary focus has to be getting out of undergrad and dental school. That means a man would be coming over and getting a portion of a woman. So for a man to come over and do that, to get a portion of a woman, a tenth of a woman, you must be a hell of a woman, because it would be better for him to go get a young woman with no children to be his full wife than just be your beta male sucker, because he ain't getting shit from you. And the reason I can say it that way is because the attitude you came in here with, like, a man gets all this stuff from me, okay.
And guys, that brings us to the end of today's video. Thanks for watching. More respect on the legend, the Godfather. May his soul rest in peace and may his name stay alive forever. Guys, continue to watch more of his content on YouTube because he got so many amazing videos on his platform. Videos that teaches you how to navigate your way around females in general, especially when you have women that have reproduced with different dudes coming in saying that they have 100% chance of getting married or something. you got to be watching more of such content so that you at least know the mindset of females so that you can be able to navigate your way around female successfully. And also, male self-improvement is also available. Those of you men that were raised in a single mother home, I think the best place for you to at least know certain things about men, being masculine, is just watching more of his content. Women that want real results, women that are looking for marriages, I mean outcomes, relationship, I think the best place for you is to be at his channel and I mean be enjoying more of his content, because he has revealed so much about dating, and that's just the best place for you to be at. And a lady like this that came into the conversation saying she has 100% of chance of getting married is just, it's just stupid, because this lady is just trying to be in the science field. So at least logic and herself should be so close, but we just can see that it's very far from each other. Herself and logic, it's just the distance between them is just so far. And I wonder how this lady is just going to be the scientist that she's talking about. And that man that has to just step into this type of situation, raising someone else's kids, has to be a sucker or just a beta male in general. Because a man that is just well off, that is knows how the world operates, know his value, know what a woman is supposed to bring to the table, will not have anything to do with a woman that has reproduced with two different dudes and also almost 30 years old. I mean, that's just stupid. If you're a man and you are going walking down the path with a lady that is almost 30 years old, I don't know your age, but if you are every bit around 35, 40 years old and you are going down the path with a lady that is in her 30s, you're stupid. I'm going to keep it real. Like, it makes no sense, because she has passed her prime. That's why the 30 is called the wall. So she passed her prime and she came to settle for you. That's you are being used as retirement benefit. That's just what it is. When that lady was around 22, 23 years old, I guarantee you everything that if you had approached this type of a lady in her early 20s for marriage, she's not going to accept you. So why should you accept her when she's around 30s that she know that she has run out of all her options? So it's just stupid on your side as a man wanting to step into this type of situation. It just doesn't make sense. Logically, it doesn't make sense. And like I said, men of value will not want to take something like that. A man that is intelligent, a man that is not beta, a man that is not just holding money, but know what being masculine is not going to be happy taking on another man's kids and probably, let me say, a used woman. No. You don't want to take something like that, because it's just detriment to your success. Whatever you'll be getting, you'll be using it to feed someone's kids, and it's stupid. So the arrogance of these type of women saying that, yeah, I have done this, reproduced with another man, terrorist, and still will get a man of value, is just arrogance, for real. Guys, that brings us to the end of today's video. Thanks for watching. More respect on the legend, the Godfather. May his soul rest in peace, and may his name stay alive forever. Guys, continue to watch more of his content on YouTube. He has so much amazing videos there. Videos that teaches you how to navigate your way around females in the dating market, especially when the dating market is as rough as it is. And you have these type of women, women that have reproduced with other dudes, thinking that they can come in and just turn around and get a Prince Charming that is going to take them on and just make their life so easy. You best believe the best place you can get information that will not put you in that situation is just the Godfather's platform. And male self-improvement, like I always tell you, if you're a guy that lack masculinity, I think watching his videos, I'm not saying it's going to give you masculinity or something, but at least it's just going to teach you certain things about masculinity. And like I always tell you guys, the gym, being into the gym or getting down for the gym is just not an option. It's something that you should be doing as a guy, because part of getting into the gym is just, you know, raising your self-confidence and all that. Because for you to be able to navigate your way around females, you gotta have confidence and all those things, because women love men that has confidence. So you gotta step into the gym, and like I always say, it's not just an option, it's just a must-do thing, and it is just what it is. Like I always tell you, focus on your goals and stay focused. Do not let anything distract you from your vision. Stay calm, stay in your hustle, and it's just gonna be great. Until we meet in the next video, peace, I'm out.